fellow scientists, it's Justin again, and welcome back to our engineering road trip. Today is actually the last day of our trip, so we are homeward bound. Wait, did that sign say Orlando? Well, that's definitely not the way we need to be driving. My directions app must be malfunctioning. I don't even really understand how these things work. I guess we should take a little detour into the world of computer engineering to figure out what is going on with this app. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to describe the role of computer engineers in designing, developing, and maintaining computer systems and programs. You'll also be able to explain how coding is used to create these systems. Let's get into it! Computer engineers are the architects of the digital world. They design, develop, and maintain computer systems and programs. That means everything from automatic traffic lights to the phone in my pocket exists thanks to the work of computer engineers. How many different devices can you list that you interact with each day? Pause the video and record what you come up with in your guided notes. Designing is the first step of the computer engineering process. Engineers begin by identifying a problem that could be solved by a computer system. A problem like, I don't know, a guy and his robot friend getting lost driving around Florida. That random, unnamed person could probably use an app that gives him directions. A computer engineer would design a program that can find the best routes, give turn-by-turn directions, and update in real time with traffic information. Once they've designed the system, the next step for the computer engineer is to develop it. This involves creating two key components, hardware and software. Hardware is all the physical parts of a computer system. For our directions app, the hardware includes the phone it will be displayed on, the GPS receiver in the phone that takes in the information, and the servers that store all the map data. These are the physical components needed for the app to function. Some computer engineers build hardware, putting together the pieces to make computers and other devices. And some utilize hardware that already exists. Look at the device you're currently using. What types of hardware does it have? Software, on the other hand, is the set of instructions that tells the hardware what to do. For our directions app, the software includes the instructions for calculating routes, for when to read out directions, and for responding to what the user inputs. But computer engineers can't just type instructions into computers and expect them to do what they're asked. Engineers need to speak to the computers in their own language. That language is code. Code is a way of writing instructions that computers can understand. These instructions are written in special languages called programming languages. They have specific rules for how the instructions have to be written. It can look kind of complicated, just like any language does before you study it. But when a computer engineer writes code, they're actually breaking down instructions into their simplest steps. A set of step-by-step directions in code is called an algorithm. Hey, since my app isn't working, maybe you can help build an algorithm to help me and Mia find the nearest computer store. So, an algorithm is a set of directions. We're over here, and we need to get over there, to the computer store. What direction do we need to go first? Okay, straight. We come to an intersection. From here, pause the video and design an algorithm or a set of directions to get us to the computer store in your guided notes. Okay, so where should we go from here? We could go a few different ways, but let's turn left. Another intersection. Let's turn right. Okay, and another left. At this intersection, we'll proceed straight, and there, we made it! We just created an algorithm! Algorithms can solve all sorts of problems, from finding routes to playing games. They're how your computer knows what to do when you click your mouse, and how your video game character knows to jump when you press A. Computer engineers try to make using devices like gaming consoles and computers as simple as possible for us, the consumers, but actually coding the program comes with challenges. Sometimes the code doesn't work the way it's expected to, like when it has bugs. Bugs in a code aren't ants or beetles, they're errors that can cause the program to malfunction. An error could be a missing step in the algorithm or a typo in the code that makes the directions inaccurate. Debugging is the process of finding and fixing these errors, and it's a big part of a computer engineer's job. Debugging can be tricky, but it's essential to make sure the software works correctly. So, a computer engineer designs a program, then develops all the algorithms that make up its code. But their work is not done yet. Even after the program is available to use, computer engineers still need to work to maintain what they've built. Maintaining a computer system is like taking care of a car. Just like how cars need regular oil changes and tune-ups, computer systems need regular updates and fixes to keep them running smoothly. This involves updating the software, fixing new bugs that might appear, and sometimes even upgrading the hardware to improve performance. Have you ever experienced a program freezing or crashing? It probably needed some maintenance. So maybe my directions app just needs an update. If that's the case, we'll ask the experts at the computer store for some help installing it. While they're working on that, let's review everything we've learned today. Computer engineers design, develop, and maintain computer systems and programs. They could develop hardware, like computers and phones, or software programs. Computer engineers use code to give computers instructions called algorithms. To learn more about computer engineering, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. So, turns out the app didn't need an update. It was working just fine. The problem was someone changed the destination when I wasn't looking so she could visit some theme parks. Well, Orlando is a hub for computer engineering. Fine, let's go. And remember, scientists, curiosity is the architect of discovery. See you next time! Hey.